of medical students. My name is Lisa, and I'm a second year medical student at the Oregon Health and Science University. Congratulations on taking the next step on your journey into medicine. So in-person medical school interviews are a little bit difficult to do right now, and I know that one of the most important and meaningful parts of in-person interviews is being able to actually go to the schools that you're interested in and look around and get a glimpse of what it's like to be an actual medical student living there. So since we can't do that right now, a few friends and I got together and put together a little virtual tour video, kind of just taking you around campus and showing you around a little bit and basically doing what we would do normally during in-person interviews. I hope this video is helpful for all of you and that everybody is staying as safe and as healthy as possible. So without further ado, let's get going.
Our first stop of the day is going to be the Robertson's Life Science Building, or RLSB for short. It's located just on the south waterfront right by the Willamette River, and it's where medical students will spend a good chunk of their first and second years. This is where the majority of the didactics portion of the curriculum is held. Joining us to talk a little bit more about the different parts of this building are a few other medical students. Starting off, we have Nikki, who you see waving oh so joyfully here, and Rachel, one of our admissions liaisons. Right now, we're heading down the hallway into the atrium of the RLSB, which is kind of like the lobby area right in the center of the building. And here is Rachel now to tell you more.
Hello, welcome inside. This is the atrium of RLSB. This is where you'll see usually a whole bunch of students gathered. We have not one, but two Starbucks because we need a lot of caffeine to get through our days. So there is the first and then the second. Back behind me, you can't see it at the moment, but we also have an Elephant's back there, which is like a nice deli where you can get real food other than just caffeine, and it's pretty great.
Thanks, Rachel. Right off the side of the atrium, in the direction where Nikki's skipping merrily towards, is our medical student lounge, which is a nice, quiet place for medical students to study.
This is the med student only quiet study space. The library was getting a little crowded, and so OHSU wanted to make sure that the med students had a space that they could call their own so that we could study and be super productive and always know that we're going to have a desk available to us. I use this space to be able to study in the mornings before class. This is an awesome spot that shows that OHSU prioritizes our education and our ability to study and make sure that med students have the resources they need in order to be successful.
Now let's get out of the med student lounge and head on back to the atrium, where we'll take some stairs up to the second floor. Where we're heading now is this little hallway with several small classrooms branching out from either side. Hello, Amy! Amy is yet another medical student who's going to tell you about what we do in this part of the building.
So this is where we do our clinical skills labs in the more clinical side of medical school. We are able to learn physical exam skills, including heart and lungs, ear or eye exams, reflexes, things like that. There's also physical exam beds so that you can have like the real experience of being in a patient room. It's also a good place to study by yourself or group study if you can't find another spot as well.
So like Amy said, those classrooms are where classes break off into smaller groups of around 12 or so people to do more focused, hands-on, discussion-based learning. Where we're going now is up one more flight of stairs to the third floor to one of our simulation centers. I can't actually walk you through there right now, so we'll just have to make do with some pictures. This is where traditionally our MMI interviews are held for medical school applicants, and is also where we put those doctory clinical skills to the test on standardized patients, who are actually actors who are kind enough to come in pretending to be patients and allow us to test various skills on them. This hallway is set up to be just like a hallway you'd see in a clinic, with lots of individual patient rooms that look exactly like a typical doctor's office. Every couple of Fridays, the medical students get to put on their white coats and stethoscopes and come pretend to be a doctor for a little bit, practicing taking a history or doing heart and lung exams in a low-stakes, pretty chill environment. These little, low-stakes, standardized patient so-called exams are some of the highlights of our didactics portion of the curriculum. Leaving the simulation center, we're just going to turn right around here and see these two rooms where all of the big group lecture-style learning happens. Right now, everything is remote learning, so it's practically a desolate wasteland, but you can see that the room doesn't look like a traditional lecture hall. We actually call this place the Learning Studio. The tables are organized so that students can work in groups and collaborate with each other, and the lectures are presented on screens that surround the perimeter of the room so that everyone can see no matter where you're sitting. On the other side of this wall is another learning studio just like this room, and when there are big events like poster fairs or match day that happen, you can remove the divider between the two rooms to get an even bigger space. Probably most importantly is that all of our lectures are recorded and posted online so you can also enjoy riveting lectures on the digestive system or the TCA cycle from the comfort of your own bed. Personally, I'm one of the rare souls who tries to actually go to every lecture, but on days when that's not possible, just because of scheduling or I just cannot do it that day, it's great to have that option available. Now we've teleported up one more flight of stairs to the fourth floor, where we're meeting up with Natasha, who's going to show us to one of the more popular study/hangout places for all different kinds of students in this building. It's given the very generic name, Grad Student Lounge.
Okay, so you need a badge to get into this room, so OHSU students only, but it is open to different schools, including dental and nursing. I think maybe physician's assistant schools. I've seen them up here. So it's sort of a shared space for everyone. We have a bunch of Keurig machines and a hot water heater and toaster for like all the coffee you need to keep you awake. Lots of microwaves and fridges for keeping your lunch in and heating them up. Those are always super helpful for me. Lots of study space in here. These chairs are really comfortable actually, and those bean bags back there are like the best place to take a nap if you can stand to take a nap while people are watching you. I think this is a really good group study space if you don't mind like a little bit of noise when you're studying. These TVs are kind of whatever you want to make them. I've seen people watch like lots of sports games in here. Just kind of a nice space to almost take a step back from school and hang out with people from all different programs. Computers, in case you don't have your laptop with you and you need something to help you study. There's also a really beautiful balcony out this way. Should we go see it? This is probably my favorite spot in the whole building. It's not really any furniture out here, but a lot of people will just bring their lunch out, sit on the ground, and just out with people, be in the sun, which this is Portland, so we don't get like that much of it. So when there is a nice day, there's a ton of people out here.
Sadly, now we have to abandon the pretty views outside, but from the grad lounge, we're now gonna head over and meet up with everybody at one of the couple libraries we have here on campus.
So, we are in our library. We have lots of group study rooms. They're a really great place to study with friends or, you know, whatever study group is working for you. So we go into one of the study rooms. This hallway is just filled with them on either side, but this is what you can see what they look like. So, small group table. There's three chairs in here, but you can add more chairs if you need to. Whiteboard to work on, which I think is super helpful. And a TV screen you can plug your computer into, so you can pull up study slides or whatever you need on the big screen. So I really like looking at the same thing. So that's kind of what all of these rooms look like. They do get pretty full, but you can reserve them if you need to, which is super helpful. This is the front desk area where you can request a book to check out. They have some books down here, but if you need any other book, then they can get you one from our main library, which is up on the hill. So up here, I think, is like a really nice, quiet-ish study space. The first floor study space is like the completely silent area, but I think this is a really good zone.
So we're back down on the ground floor, and that's pretty much it for the RLSB. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna take you guys, we're gonna head out to the tram, head up the hill, and see what we can see up there. Let's go! As we walk over to the tram to head up the hill, you can see that the RLSB is right next to a bunch of public transportation. Sometimes when things get busy, it can be difficult to access this place via car, and sometimes parking feels limited, but it's always fairly easy to get here via public transportation. Interrupt this tranquil stroll to the tram to show you a couple notable things right next to the tram station. First, straight ahead of us is the Center for Health and Healing Building 1, or CHH1. It's got a bunch of OHSU outpatient clinics, a pharmacy, and a cafe and coffee stand, and it also houses the March Wellness and Fitness Center, which is a gym that OHSU students have access to. Right under the tram is free valet bike parking. Portland is a very bike-friendly city, and many students and staff commute here by a bike, and this is a great place to store your bike for the day. They also provide repairs, tune-ups, and air for a price if you're ever in need of that. Okay, that's enough of that. Let's head up the tram to the main OHSU hospital. Enjoy the view! Since the hospital is built into the side of Markham Hill, we're actually on the 9th floor of the hospital. We just passed through Kohler Pavilion and we're heading over to the main lobby. From here, we'll take a left and pass by the gift shop to the end of this hall where it splits into two bridges.
Alright guys, I'm going to show you one of the coolest things I love about this place. Let's go!
This is actually a sky bridge that will lead to the Veterans Affairs Medical Center. It's the longest pedestrian suspension bridge in North America. From here, you can get a look at the other bridge, which in itself actually is the Dornbecker's Children's Hospital, which is really cool. From here, we're going to retrace our steps back past the hospital gift shop again with the cutest orchid plushies in the world. I have the lung one, and I love it. Exiting the hospital, we're going to head up along this parking lot past several other hospital buildings, which house some clinics and administration offices. Over and across the street, you can see our main library, the BIC, which stands for the Biomedical Information Communication Center. Yeah, it's the library. The staff here are a great resource to students and are super helpful if you ever need any help doing searches or literature reviews or anything like that. Here by the fountain is a really nice courtyard area. During the summer months, once a week, there's a little farmer's market which different vendors sell fresh produce and foods. Last time I went, they had a tamale stand, which was bomb. Back here is Mackenzie Hall, or Mac Hall, which was the first building on the Markham Hill campus. It houses the School of Medicine Dean's Office, as well as financial aid and registrar staff. Next door on the right, we've got Baird Hall, which houses our Student Health and Wellness Center. From here, we're going to go around the building past this half-head statue, which, although spooky when encountered in the dead of night, symbolizes the mysteries of the human mind and our eternal search for knowledge, which is also pretty cool. This is the Richard Jones Hall, or RJH, which houses Virtue OHSU, which is our simulation and surgical training center. It also houses our cadaver lab that we use for anatomy, which is, personally, my favorite part of medical school so far.
This is our anatomy lab and surgical simulation center. So something that's really awesome and available to us as students is some of the interest groups will put on surgical simulation courses where in your free time you can come up here and learn how to do coronary artery bypass grafts on pig hearts. There's also laparoscopic technique and suture classes and things like that. But then everybody has to also go in and do the dissection lab for our anatomy course. This is one of the coolest parts of OHSU and one of the most awesome parts where you get to start feeling like, wow, I'm a medical student and I'm here doing actual medical things. So look forward to getting to go inside when you get here.
In addition to Virtue OHSU, which is all the simulation stuff, RJH is also the location of the Center for Diversity and Inclusion offices up on the fourth floor. But now, as you can see, we're leaving RJH and we're going to pass through the library, down to the street level, and make our way back through the hospital and over to the Student Center, which is our last stop of the day.
This is the student center. Here we have a gym to work out, like a smaller version of it. There's a pool up here to swim if you're into that. And then there's also a huge gym where we do a lot of IM sports, including like the IM basketball league and the volleyball league play here. Also, there's a huge movie screen that you could do group movies in here. Some comfy like beanbags to hang out at. So I think it's just kind of a nice place to chill out if you're on campus, on the hill, and need a place to study. Also, it's like the warmest building in the wintertime, so that's why it's a favorite of mine for studying.
Thank you all of you for joining us on this little trek through our school. And at the end here, I just want to express again that I hope this video has been at least somewhat helpful for everyone. This whole medical school application process is one heck of an endeavor, especially when things are the way they are. And I really, really hope that this kind of more down-to-earth, low-key experience helps make things feel a little bit more realistic and tangible. You will get through this, and you will become great doctors. So keep on keeping on. We'll see you soon.